Welcome to the Travel Planners TV show. This segment features Pontiac, Illinois, a city in central Illinois on what was Route 66, now Interstate 55. One of the great museums, and there are a lot of them in Pontiac, is the Route 66 History Museum. In it, you will find anything and everything you want to know about Route 66, including license plates, old diner tables and accessories, road signs, gas pumps. In fact, this gas pump is the old hand pump type. The big glass container you would pump the handle on the side, fill it with gas, and then read the numbers down as to how many gallons you wanted to distribute. Road signs were big on Route 66. And who could forget Cozy Dogs, the go-to diner item on Route 66. Next, we went to the Museum of Gilding Arts. We found this very fascinating. Here we learned about gold leaf. It dates back to ancient Egypt. We were surprised by how many different items in our regular daily life are gold-plated, including door numbers, sewing machines, portions of vehicles, and we saw how gold leafing was done back in the day. It's hard to believe that this was all originally done with hand tools. The courthouse on the town square is actually the third courthouse for Livingston County. It was completed in 1875 and is listed on the National Register of Historical Places. The original cost was set at $75,000. That's more than $12 million today, with only $50 allowed for cost overruns. They say the contractors lost over $15,000 on the job. The Pontiac County Arts Center features many, many local artists' items. Everything from paintings to ceramics, furniture, and more. Art workshops and classes are also available there. The history of the Pontiac Oakland Museum and Resource Center in Pontiac began August 1st of 2010 when Tim Dye was on his way back to his home in Oklahoma. He'd been at a Pontiac car show in Chicago. As he drove south on I-55, he saw the sign for the city of Pontiac and decided to see what it was all about. He pulled into town, explored the city, visited the International Waldog Mural and Sign Art Museum, and struck up a conversation with the museum's director and said, "If you ever think about having a Pontiac car museum here, give me a call." The next day, the museum manager contacted the Pontiac mayor, who gave Tim a call, and the grand opening day took place July 23, 2011, less than 1 year from the time Tim first visited Pontiac. And this statue is not just an advertising item for Pontiac automobiles. There actually was a Chief Pontiac. He was an Ottawa leader who became famous for his role in Pontiac's Rebellion, an American Indian struggle against the British military occupation of the Great Lakes region. He also gained stature in the Illinois and Wabash country as he continued to encourage resistance to the British. Their Resource Center library has several thousand old highway maps, sales brochures, original design drawings, and service and owner's manuals. If it was printed about the Pontiac or Oakland Auto Brand, they probably have a copy of it. There are also thousands of Pontiac and Oakland-related items and an incredible display of more than 2,000 oil cans. They change their displays several times a year, so there's always something new in the museum. This old-time camper trailer comes complete with a kitchen, and a newer version was done with a pop-up tent on the back of a late-model Pontiac. And here's one that nobody's ever seen before because there was only one of them made and it was never released, and that was a four-seater Fiero. It was a prototype that never saw the streets. Various types of Pontiac motors from the early days right up to the big Pontiac Tri-Power V8s. 3 2-barrel carburetors. Wow. Some were even turbocharged. Many other Pontiac items are in the museum, including this bicycle. Model cars of every style of Pontiac ever made. The Lincoln County War Museum invites you to tour their 20th century collection of artifacts, films, books, uniforms, and weapons from all of America's military conflicts, from World War I right up through Iraq and Afghanistan. All of the items represent service members from Livingston County. The museum does not glorify war, but shows the best attributes of men and women caught up in war. In doing so, they respectfully honor the service of all of America's veterans, past and present. If you scan these QR codes, you will be able to read and hear a history of each one of these local veteran stories. It's an amazing collection that has been put together by local veterans who also conduct tours of the museum.
This is one of the most famous uniforms in here. It's ISIL Hambleton, but everybody knows him better as Bat 21 from Vietnam. What happened was he was 52 years old. He was a U.S. missile expert, and he was working in the Pentagon. And they got the bright idea, let's pull him out of the Pentagon, put him in that airplane, and fly him up to Saigon. And he was to map the route for the B-52s to take so they could bomb Hanoi. During that flight, unbeknownst to them, during the night, the North Vietnamese moved two of the missile sites. So they went flying up there that day. Every warning device in that plane went off, and the pilot yelled, eject, eject. They punched out of the airplane, and he was the only one that made it out alive. He landed on the ground, and he crawled off into the underbrush, and he knew if he turned on his survival radio, he'd get captured in about 2 minutes. So he remained silent for the first 2 weeks, and he kept crawling away from where he had crashed. 2 weeks later, he turned the radio back on and reestablished communication with the Americans, but what he did, he knew if he talked anything they understood, they'd come capture him immediately. this guy was an avid golfer. This is a crazy story, but he used golf holes. He says, I'm on Hickam Field, I'm on hole 9, or I'm on Anderson Air Force Base, I'm on hole 12. And he went from golf hole to golf hole every night. 21 days later, this Navy SEAL paddled up the river, hiked inland about 5 miles, picked old Lysol up over his shoulders and carried him out of there, and he made it back alive. Well, it was the biggest rescue of the entire Vietnam War. And they made Hollywood made the movie out of it, Bat 21. You can go buy the video in any video store. Still's out there. And those two books were written. The eagle here is made up of all people. They're all dated, and it tells where they were taken, how many people were in the picture, and so on and so forth. The aerial photography took over, and they didn't have to do this anymore. So how do you think they took those pictures? Hot air balloon.
Really?
They loaded the old Graf-X box camera, which looks like a surveyor's tripod with a big wood box on top. They loaded that in a hot air balloon. And then on day one, they had their crew go out, put colored number flags all around the outline of what they wanted to create. The way they did it's ridiculous. They took a grease pen, and in this case, they drew an eagle on the lens of the camera. Took it up in the air, aimed it at the ground, and they directed their guys to put all the colored number flags out.
Wow.
That took a whole day. Day two, they started building the pictures, one row of people at a time. Took another week to make one picture. Audie Murphy's uniform is here for one reason. Our buddy over here, John Rodino, who they named Rodino Square in Pontiac after, he is the one who was his radio man the whole war. Everybody in town here knows him as a football coach and a teacher. So they served together all of World War II.
The Life in the 1940s exhibit is located on the second floor of the Pontiac Museum complex. The exhibit features 4 rooms completely furnished with furniture and knickknacks from the era. The exhibit also has a display of original newspapers and the most significant headlines of World War II, children's toys, and a Titanic exhibit complete with a diary from an onboard passenger are also on display. And be sure to stop into the Stage Door Canteen, a replica of a New York canteen for military personnel that was staffed by movie stars and entertainers. You'll always enjoy some vintage 1940s music, and if you're lucky, you might even get a trombone solo from the director of the museum.
In 1860, Jason Stravell, whose house this was, invited Mr. Lincoln to speak at the local Methodist church. So he gave a speech, and afterward they came to this house. And Stravell and Lincoln were talking. Stravell said, "Well, Mr. Lincoln, I don't quite believe you're 6'4". And, he says, "Well, let's see." So he takes off his shoes, Mr. Lincoln, and he stands here. And Mr. Stravell got a measuring stick, and it was exactly 6'4".
The Stravell House at 401 West Livingston Street is one of many connections Pontiac has to Abraham Lincoln. One of the most interesting revolves around Lincoln's friendship with local attorney Jason W. Stravell. Stravell suggested that Lincoln might be selected as the Republican Party's presidential candidate at the upcoming party convention. Lincoln argued that he might be chosen as vice presidential candidate, but he certainly didn't think he would be picked for the top spot on the ticket. Pontiac is home to 23 outdoor murals, which in addition to being beautiful pieces of public art, they also depict the local history. Most of the murals can be seen from your car, but a walking tour is the best way to see them. You just follow the red painted footprints on the downtown sidewalks. The blue footprints go to all the museums. You can also use your mobile device to scan the QR code located under or next to many of the murals to guide you from one to the next and hear a bit about their design and significance. One thing for sure, when you visit Pontiac, Illinois, you won't go hungry. Many local restaurants feature great home-style American cooking. And not unlike the old supper clubs, most of them have bar service as well. The only thing missing is that relish tray. There are also healthy items on the menu. And that world-famous Route 66 cozy dog, the corn dog on a stick. And everybody has great homemade pie. There's some pretty good carrot cake available, too. And a relatively new addition to Pontiac is Wally's, the home of the Great American Road Trip. This is a huge automotive superstore. Complete with their own woody wagon and more than 70 gas pumps. If you can't find it at Wally's, you don't need it. And rest assured, there's something of interest for everyone in the family when you visit Pontiac, Illinois.